Uh-huh.
You said you wanted to be a cartoonist, but what's so great about that?
Well, just... think of it.
That girl is so lazy, it takes her forever to roll out of bed on the weekends.
You can create whatever kind of world you want out of your imagination.
Mijo!
Love and magic are all at your command!
What are you doing?
Chisa?
How long have you been up? Why didn't you come downstairs? Dad and I have already finished breakfast.
I don't want any breakfast.
Don't tell me you're on a diet.
Good cover-up, but it's not good for you to skip breakfast.
But I don't have time for breakfast. Let's see, maybe this one.
Come on now, Mijo. Huh? I wonder where Pog went.
Here we go!
Pog!
Well, if she's not gonna eat her breakfast, I will. After all, I'm starving. Oh.
Got it! Okay, now I'll transform.
And then what'll you do?
What do you think? Now that I can transform, I'm gonna get all dolled up and then cruise through town like a real grown-up.
Well, while you're at it, Mijo, why not go downstairs and show your sister what you look like after you've transformed?
Huh? Just pencil me in for one day during the holidays so we can go shopping together, please? Huh? Imaichi, you aren't serious.
I've got a problem. I can't get outside without walking past her. I'll never get away with a transformation.
Why not? Would there be a problem if your sister saw you?
She would call the police if she found a complete stranger roaming around the house up here.
The police?
Don't you realize what would happen if people found out about all this magic?
Haven't got a clue.
You, Mog?
Well, I'm beginning to get a picture of it.
I don't have a choice. I'm going out like this, and I'll change outside.
I'm going too. Please
take me.
Me
too.
No way. I'd stand out like a sore thumb if you two came along with me.
Maybe not.
Huh?
What? Imaichi, isn't Shoto that guy who was in your class in junior high and he dropped out of school already?
You're kidding. Right? Uh-huh.
Hmm?
Uh-huh. Take care. Boss, So what's up with the catalog shoot today?
Well, it starts at 1 this afternoon.
It hasn't been postponed with any luck.
Going as planned. It's an enormous opportunity for our company to do Facil's mail order catalog. We'd never miss this chance.
Linda, our top model for the shoot, just called in sick.
What do you mean sick?
Her face is covered in spots.
Covered?
And they're bright red.
Can't we do something?
There's nothing we can do.
I'm going out. Rurika, come with me.
Yes, ma'am.
Hey, be sure to drive safely.
Yoshio, you're going too.
Why do I have to go?
You expect the boss to do her own driving?
Oh, there's nowhere to transform here.
Why do you have to transform and walk around town anyway?
You can walk around as you are now.
But I'm eager to test everything out.
Test what out?
I want to see if people think I'm beautiful after I transform.
How about in the shadow of that truck over there?
That'll do. Loosen, baby. What a tiresome kind of magic to have to get changed every time.
bracelets don't really match my clothing.
No problem.
Don't you think I look a bit strange?
Yes, you do.
I look strange?
Mm-hmm. You said yourself that you transform into a complete stranger, so...
A stranger, not strange. You look just fine. You're beautiful.
Really think so?
Where's that?
The other day, during spring vacation, my sister Chisa was approached by a scout while she was in Harajuku.
By a skirt?
No, S-C-O-U-T, scout. He asked if she'd be interested in becoming a big star, but... apparently, he was a fake, trying to rip her off by charging an agent's fee.
What did she do?
Do you have any idea who my father is? You say another word and your body will be floating in the Pacific Ocean by tomorrow morning.
She gave him what for and walked away.
So why go to such a scary place?
It's not really a scary place, you know. All kinds of famous people go there, too.
Famous people?
Maybe that adorable Hiroya from TV will ask me out on a date today.
Hi. I thought you were beautiful from a distance. You're even more lovely close up. I hope you don't find this forward, but would you have dinner with me?
Oh! This is our stop! Ugh!
No, that won't do. This upcoming special summer issue, fashionable swimsuits and sportswear with matching accessories, is our most important issue.
I completely understand, sir. I'm sorry. Can't we postpone the shoot by a day?
I told you, we can't delay any longer. Besides, the wardrobe we brought here is sized specifically for the model Linda.
But what if...
If you can't replace her, we'll just have to hire another model agency.
All I ask is that you give me 30 minutes to see who I can find.
Huh?
Hey, you didn't pay the full adult fare!
Oh, yeah!
I just gave a note to Okada.
Do you think he'll write back?
I don't know!
I'm starving.
Oh, is that all you can think about?
Let's eat something, Mio!
Quiet! Stop shouting into my ear all the time!
Huh? Was I shouting into your ear?
Huh?
Would you be interested in following me for a moment?
What?
Great, look! I'd like you to do some camera testing. Okay? This could be your opportunity to be a star. Well?
No, thanks.
Wait a minute, I'm serious.
Stop it!
There's nothing to be afraid of, honest.
My dad will take you to the Pacific Ocean and he'll...
Huh? What did you say?
No, nobody. Right. Yes. Our company just doesn't have the resources. We're really lacking when it comes to backup talent.
I've checked the files of all our models, but none of them match Linda's measurements.
I see.
The only thing left for us to do is to turn down this opportunity and apologize.
Boss, I'm not saying I'm a model or anything, but maybe our only option is to have me do the shoot.
Linda's 35-25-35. Don't tell me you have those proportions.
Size that up. Well, boss, how about it? What do you say? Boss?
The gods of destiny have decided to shine upon us today, Rurika. We are sure to get along well.
Thank you.
I brought you in some coffee, Dad.
Mm-hmm.
Dad, you really enjoy your research, don't you?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Couldn't be happier. Having your beautiful teenage daughter serve you delicious coffee makes you want to buy her something, doesn't it?
Didn't I just buy you some clothes the other day?
That was back when I started the seventh grade.
What? You've outgrown those?
By the way, Dad.
Hmm?
How on earth did you manage proposing to Mother? I would love to know, Dad.
Well, why don't we just go shopping, Chisa?
My name is Yumi Haneishi. I'm the president of Lyrical Productions. It's a modeling agency. What's your name?
Me? No, I'm Fancy Lala.
How old?
I guess I'm, well, around 15.
Lala, you're not too busy right now, are you?
Huh? Why do you ask?
You haven't already signed a contract with a different agency, have you?
What do you mean by a contract?
Try laughing for me. Hurry. Well, I'm sure you'll do just fine.
Huh?
Ririka, please take Lala over to Komi's place right now.
Sure.
She's good, the replacement. Can she do what Linda can do?
She sure can. Wait and see.
So this is the first job you've ever had?
Uh-huh. Everything's so new.
That's Miss Haneishi. She's always taking chances, but it seems she really likes you, Lala.
Do you really think so?
The Facile catalog is an extremely important project for Lyrical Productions. We wouldn't use just anybody now.
Here's your first outfit, Lala.
Now change into that piece.
To be honest, I've never modeled before.
Look, you've gotten this far, so have pride in yourself and try to enjoy the moment.
Nice to meet you. I hear this is your first shoot. Hey, don't worry. The pictures will be great, okay? All right, first we'll take some test shots. Place your hands on your hip. That's right. That's good. Now, look over at the... look over towards Komi. Here, look at these Polaroids of yourself.
Okay. Wow.
Now, let's get started. That's good. You look great.
Actually, I think she's not doing too badly.
Not too badly? I think she's doing great.
I wonder, where in the world did she come from?
Ririka, go find Yoshio and tell him to order lunch for everybody right away.
Okay, whatever you say, boss.
I think the swimwear is next, right? Why don't we put this on now? I'm taking your earrings off, okay?
Okay.
How are you enjoying modeling so far?
I think I'll end up being okay. I really appreciate your help.
No need to thank me. I'm just doing my job.
Lala, let me just say, you're starting to get really good at this.
Miss Haneishi?
Yes?
What's the girl's name?
Oh, her name is Lala.
I'd like to use her again for our special fall issue, Fashion for the Breezy Autumn and Beauty Tips for Daily Living. How's that?
Thank you. That sounds wonderful. Yoshio, all I said was to get lunch for everybody. Who said anything about a 5-star buffet of sushi?
But Ririka said...
What? You went ahead and ordered the most expensive one on the menu. I had nothing to do with it.
Lala, please help yourself. All you can eat.
Thanks. I sure have been.
This is delicious!
So tasty.
Take it easy, you guys.
So, Lala?
Yes?
Do you want me to write you a check for today's work, or should we set up a direct deposit?
No.
All right, we can figure it out later. Can you give me your address and phone number at least?
I can't really.
Please?
I just can't do that.
Are you afraid that your parents might have a problem with you working as a model?
No, it's nothing like that, it's just...
Then what? What's bothering you?
I'm sorry.
Boss, Lala seems to have a problem with that.
I'm actually the one who has the problem now.
She doesn't have a problem with her appetite.
Hi, Rurika. So how's the boss? What? How can she be happy and sad at the same time? What do you mean? Let me talk to her.
Boss, it's Emiko.
Hello? What? Was it Mr. Hanma of Ekron TV who called? So, they made a youthful co-host for their variety show? I see. Well, call him back and tell him that we have the perfect person for the position. Yes, that's right.
Miho, where have you been?
Chisa, is that a new dress? Tell me where you got it!
I figured why not buy some clothes for my daughters. Miho, we'll have to go out and buy you some clothes, too.
Let me think now, what would I really like? I'd rather have my own bank account than clothes, Dad. Do you think you could arrange that for me?
A bank account?
Don't tell me you've been saving your allowance money.
Well, sort of.
Really?
I sure wouldn't mind staying in this comfy world a bit longer.
Sometimes I think you're so lucky to be so simple-minded, Pog.
Sure you want to get off here? We'd be happy to take you right to your door.
I'm positive. I can get home alone from here.
Hold on to this. Now, why don't you say yes to at least one of my requests, huh?
But what should I take that for?
I want to keep in contact with you, Lala. I don't want to lose you.
What? Now? Hello?
Hello, is this Ms. Hanaishi?
No, I'm not her.
Oh, I'm sorry. I must have the wrong number.
No, it's not the wrong number exactly. This is Miss Hanaishi's phone. She just gave it to me to hold on to.
I see. Then, are you a model at Lyrical Productions?
Yeah. Something like that, I guess.
My name is Hiroya Aikawa.
Hiroya Aikawa? The real one?
What's your name?
My name? It's Fancy Lala.
Lala. Who knows? Maybe we'll work together someday.
I guess that you could be right.
I look forward to it, Lala.
Yes, me too. And I look forward to meeting you.
I'll try contacting Ms. Hanaishi in a few days. Bye.
Thank you. Me? A model? But I get this feeling that anything's possible when I become Lala. It's amazing!